This is Dan Dix here reporting for Press for Truth. I have breaking news to share with you today, the significance of which is huge. I feel we are leading towards a major conflict in the Middle East between Syria and Russia and the Israeli, Saudi Arabian, U.S. allied forces. And I have discovered something that no one is talking about, but as soon as I post this video and it gets shared, everyone is going to be discussing the significance of this. So today I'm asking that you will please share this video as soon as you are done watching it. Here's what I found today. All right, guys, we have some major developments to cover in regards to this ongoing and escalating war in Syria. And in this video, we're going to expose the number one company that we all need to keep an eye on here moving forward. And also just who the major players are when it comes to these global elitists and their plans to take this proxy war in Syria to the next level. And it's not just about oil, guys. This is about total control of the Middle East. And of course, you're not going to get any of this information anywhere from the mainstream media because they don't want you to know about this. So if you appreciate coverage like this, be sure to support us on Patreon so we can continue uncovering this kind of information that the mainstream media is either constantly just censoring or they're either just completely unaware of it because they're bought and paid for and controlled, unlike us who are beholden to you, the viewers. Now, before we can get into the significance of what I found here, we need to provide some background information for context. And we're going to start back in 2009 when Qatar proposed a pipeline plan to Assad in order to send its natural gas into Europe through Saudi Arabia, Syria, and Jordan. Now, Assad refused this offer in order to, quote, protect the interest of its Russian ally, which is Europe's top supplier of natural gas. So Assad essentially just said thanks, but no thanks. And then 1 year later, Assad began negotiations for another pipeline plan, only this one is going to carry Iranian gas to Europe across Iraq and Syria. And of course, if this were to be built, Europe's dependence on Russia is going to continue, and that is in Assad's best interest. Now, here, many journalists have correctly pointed out that the U.S.-backed Qatar-Turkey pipeline into Europe is in direct competition with, and in fact, in direct conflict with the Russian-backed Iranian-Syrian pipeline into Europe. And this has led many to speculate that this current proxy war in Syria right now has everything to do with maintaining the flow of gas and energy into Europe through these particular pipelines. But what I have discovered here paints a bit of a different picture, because according to my research, the X that marks the spot, so to speak, is not here, but it is in fact down here in a region known as Golan Heights. This is on Syria's land, but two-thirds of it is occupied by Israeli forces, and here's where it gets interesting. In 2013, a company called Genie Oil and Gas was granted exclusive oil and gas exploration rights to this 153 square mile radius here in the southern part of the Golan Heights, and this was granted to them by none other than the Netanyahu government. And as it turns out, in 2015, it was discovered that this Israeli-occupied Golan Heights in Syria has more oil and gas than Saudi Arabia does. Guys, this is huge because you can now officially add Israel into the mix when it comes to potentially sparking World War III, all because of oil in Syria. Now, it has yet to be put into production, but odds are that that soon will be the case, because just look at who I discovered is on the strategic advisory board of Genie Oil and Gas. You've got names like Dick Cheney, Rupert Murdoch, Jacob Rothschild, and James Wolseley, just to name a few. This isn't your average oil company here, folks. These guys want to spark World War III, so let's get to the bottom here of just who they are and why they have such heavy hitters here, politically speaking, on their advisory board. So let's start with the founder of Genie Energy, the chief executive officer and the chairman of the board, Howard Jonas. As you can see here from his bio, he's obviously no stranger to the oil and gas industry, having been involved as far back as 2006. And it's estimated that Jonas is sitting on top of reserves in excess of 10 billion barrels of oil in the United States, and 40 billion barrels in Israel. So when you add that up, it's quite significant when compared to the likes of Saudi Arabia. Now let's go through who Howard Jonas strategically picked here to be on his advisory board. First, we have Michael Steinhardt. According to Forbes magazine, he is the pioneer of modern hedge funds. And his net worth right now, as of March 2017, is in excess of $1 billion. He's also the founder of Birthright Israel, which, as we see here, is an educational organization that sponsors free 10-day heritage trips to Israel for young adults and of Jewish heritage. And that's quite the interesting symbol he's got going on over there, but perhaps that's for another video altogether. Next up, we have Richard, a.k.a. Dick Cheney, CEO of Halliburton Company and U.S. Secretary of Defense from 1989 to 1993. Now, Halliburton, of course, is one of the world's largest oil field services servicing companies. They have operations already in 80 countries around the world. And the controversies surrounding Halliburton, as you can see here, are as grand in scope as their global reach has become. But that didn't stop Jonas from putting Cheney on his advisory board over here at Genie Oil and Gas. Next up, we've got Mary Landrieu. She served as the chair of the Senate Committee for Energy and Natural Resources. And according to her bio here at Genie Oil and Gas, it was her who sponsored and passed the U.S.-Israel Energy Cooperation Bill. So it's no brainer here why she's on the board, folks. It's all about political sway and influence in order to guarantee at least a backdoor into Syria. Next up, we have Rupert Murdoch, founder and executive chairman of News Corporation, one of the world's largest diversified media companies. News Corporation's holdings include Fox Entertainment, Dow Jones & Company, The New York Post, HarperCollins, and significant media assets on six continents. I wonder why they would want to have him involved. Could it be that it has anything to do with utilizing the media to once again sway the opinions of the masses to be in favor of a Syrian invasion? Blaming Assad for chemical attacks on his own people was just the beginning of the propaganda here, folks, and I think it's about to get a lot worse. Next up, we have Bill Richardson. He's the former U.S. Secretary of Energy under the Clinton administration. He's another major player here in the energy sector, not to mention a former Bohemian Grove attendee who was sweating bullets when he was questioned about it here by Luke Radowski and our good friends over at We Are Change. I'll include links to this and to everything else contained in this video in the description below. Now moving on, we have none other than Jacob Rothschild. Yes, this is the Jacob Rothschild of the Rothschild banking dynasty. But his interests are not just in fiat currency. Turns out he's a bit of an oil tycoon himself. And in 2003, Rothschild came under scrutiny when Russian oil industrialist Mikhail Kordonovsky's shares in Yukos passed to him under a deal that they concluded prior to Chordonovsky's arrest. So, shady dealings to say the least, already when it comes to Rothschild and big oil. A perfectly suitable candidate for Howard Jonas's advisory board here at Genie Gas and Oil. Next on the list is Dr. Lawrence Summers. He served as the 71st Secretary of the Treasury under President Clinton, and he just so happens to be a member of the Bilderberg Group, this very secretive and very nefarious organization who we've covered extensively here at Press for Truth. Again, I'll leave links in the description if you want to learn more about that. And last but certainly not least, we have James Woolsey. He is the former director of the CIA, and he's the co-founder of the United States Energy Security Council. Folks, this man is currently going around, he's all over the news right now, screaming that we need to, quote, strike Iran's nuclear operations as part of any military effort against Syrian President Bashar al-Assad. So, again, a perfect contender here for Genie Oil and Gas, a company who is fully prepared to do whatever it's going to take to secure these reserves. and to work with the United States and Israel, not Russia and Syria, when it comes to exporting these goods to Europe and beyond. So folks, please help me expose this plan by Genie, Gas and Oil, and all of their globalist, elitist insider buddies here to destabilize Syria in an effort to secure some massive oil reserves that were just found in 2015.